So you've decided you want to protect your workloads on AWS. Veeam Backup for AWS is the perfect solution for that. Hi, I'm Julia with Veeam, and today we're going to start our video series on Veeam Backup for AWS and learn how to deploy our backup appliance. Let's go! Once Veeam Backup and Replication is deployed, the first step is to navigate to our backup infrastructure, and on Manage Servers, right-click and select Add Server. This is where we can add all the infrastructure that we want to protect through Veeam Backup and Replication. We'll select Veeam Cloud Native Backup Appliance and then Veeam Backup for AWS. Now, we have two choices. We can connect to an existing appliance or we can deploy a new one, which is what we'll choose to do. Click Next. Now, we add our AWS account by providing the AWS access key. Unless you want to use the GovCloud AWS region, you can leave the default global region. Then, pick the data center where you want to deploy the appliance. If it's your first time deploying a Veeam Backup for AWS appliance, click on this link and accept the license agreement. Now, give the instance a name and a description if you want. We'll call it VBR AWS Demo. You can also change the instance type if necessary. Here, we have the option of picking either a dynamic, static, or private IP address for this instance. We're going to keep the dynamic IP option. Now, we can choose to either use existing VPC configurations or create new ones for the appliance to use. For this instance, we're just going to create a new one, and Veeam Backup and Replication will handle everything needed, configuring all the networking required for this to work. Next, we create some administrator credentials for the appliance and pick a key pair. We can use an existing key pair or we can create a new one if desired. Now, it's just a matter of waiting for the appliance to deploy. While we let this finish, I want to remind you that you can download the Veeam Backup for AWS free edition on our website. Once the appliance is deployed, we're presented with a summary of our configuration options. We also have the ability to create an S3 backup repository directly through Veeam Backup and Replication. So we tick the box to enable that and simply click Finish. This allows us to configure the backup repository. Here we select the appliance that we've already configured and give the repository a name and a description if we want. Then, we choose the AWS account that we added in the credentials earlier. We can keep the default AWS region and proceed. With our data center already selected, we click Browse to find our S3 buckets. We can choose a pre-existing bucket or create a new one. We can also tick this box if we want to make our backups immutable for the entire duration of their retention policy. If we desire, we can enable backup file encryption and choose to use a KMS key or a password for encryption. Once the backup repository is registered, we're presented with a summary again, giving us all the details about what we've configured. We simply click Finish. And there we have it. Our AWS backup appliance has been deployed, and we can now protect our workloads natively through Veeam Backup and Replication. And that's it! It's that easy to deploy Veeam Backup for AWS. There is so much more to learn, and we're going to go through it all in depth in our video series. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to drop them in the area below. And don't forget to subscribe so you can see our content as soon as it's released.